Bonjour tout le monde. I want to begin by thanking the people of Charlottetown and Prince Edward Island for being such wonderful hosts these past few days. I've been on the island already a couple of times this summer, and it's such a special part of Canada. We've got the whole team here. We've had a productive retreat, and I know we're all really excited for the work ahead. But let me start, though, with a quick update on the wildfire situation out west and in the north. We're relieved to hear that fires may be coming under control and that critical infrastructure in the Northwest Territories remains intact. At Monday's Incident Response Group meeting, Minister Sajjan updated us from the ground in BC. We also discussed how to make sure people from the Northwest Territories can return home when it's safe. The Canadian Armed Forces continue to be deployed on the ground to support, and Service Canada is helping evacuees. We're on the ground, we are helping, and we will continue to be there. I want to thank all the brave firefighters battling blazes across the country this summer. I want to again thank all Canadians who've stepped up to open their communities, to open their homes to people fleeing in difficult times. Canadians really show who they are when we're constantly there to help out each other. Notre gouvernement pense à toutes les personnes touchées par les feux de forêt. On va continuer de suivre la situation et on va continuer d'être là pour tout le monde. Now, the world has faced a lot of shocks over the past few years, from the pandemic, to Putin's illegal invasion of Europe, to global inflation, to a worsening climate emergency, and Canadians have felt it and are feeling it every step of the way. From the very first meeting of this new cabinet to this retreat, I've told ministers that our most important job is to protect the promise of Canada, to build a society where, when people work hard, they get ahead, where Canadians are safe in their communities and in the world, where they're secure in the knowledge that the services they rely on, from health care to income support after retirement, will continue to be there for them, where we're building an economy focused on the middle class and people working hard to join it. On fait face à plusieurs défis, mais je peux vous dire que notre équipe est très motivée. Au cours de l'été, on a rencontré des gens partout au pays. On les a écoutés. Cette semaine, on a eu l'occasion d'entendre des experts. Notre priorité continue d'être de faire tout ce qui est en notre pouvoir pour que les gens puissent mener la vie qu'ils souhaitent. So let me talk to you about two of our core priorities. The first is the rising cost of housing. Canadians in the middle class, who are working hard to join it, are up against this challenge, and this is a challenge that's been decades in the making. Our government has been stepping up over the past years. At this retreat, we studied historical trends and data from StatCan's long-form census, which are helping us understand these issues even more clearly. Yesterday, we heard from experts and directly from Canadians who are facing these problems. Everyone agrees that it's a complex issue that requires solutions that bring together all orders of government, the private sector, and the nonprofit sector. From zoning, to corporations heating homes as assets, to the rising cost of building supplies, there's no doubt that we all have a lot of work to do. Because more and more vulnerable people are at risk of homelessness. Middle-class Canadians who want to build equity through home ownership feel increasingly like that dream is out of reach. And now more and more renters in the housing market means rising demand is causing rent to rise for everyone. So this government is focused on getting more housing built and making sure families have places to grow. Selon des rapports publiés récemment, on doit tous se donner comme défi d'en faire plus. Et on doit le faire ensemble à l'échelle du pays. On doit bâtir un marché du logement qui fonctionne pour les gens. On est tous d'accord qu'il faut unir nos efforts à travers le secteur du logement. Notre équipe est déterminée à poursuivre le travail qu'on a déjà commencé avec des programmes comme la Stratégie nationale sur le logement, les fonds pour accélérer la construction de logements qui aident à augmenter l'offre de logements et le compte d'épargne libre d'impôt pour l'achat d'une première propriété qui aide les gens à épargner en vue d'une mise de fonds. As a federal government, we're going to continue working hard and showing leadership to bring all sectors together and all orders of government. Because it takes all of us working together to get this done. To date, we've helped almost 2 million Canadians find a place to call home, and we're currently on a path to double construction of new housing over the next decade so we can meet the growing housing needs of Canadians. Deuxièmement, aujourd'hui, je veux parler d'une autre de nos priorités, de faire en sorte que la prochaine génération de Canadiens puisse réussir. On ne peut pas parler des coûts du logement sans parler de l'impact sur les jeunes. Que ce soit d'être propriétaire ou locataire, la prochaine génération vit énormément de stress avec la question du logement. To young Canadians, I want to say something. You've had two crucial years of adulthood dramatically interrupted by COVID, and then you were hit by global inflation and increased interest rates. These events upended your educations, your first jobs, your early years of building a career and a network. So we've been working hard to make sure that our economy has great jobs for you. We've eliminated interest on loans for your education. And we're helping you save up to buy a home, but we know there's lots more to do. We owe it to you to take action so you can fully benefit from the promise of Canada. So you can succeed and access all the opportunities that generations before you had, so that you can have both a healthy economy and a healthy environment in strong, vibrant communities long into the future. As a team, this is one of our top priorities. Les membres de notre Conseil des ministres s'assurent de rendre des comptes et de tenir toutes les promesses qu'on a faites aux Canadiens. De continuer à offrir des garderies accessibles, abordables et de qualité à travers le pays. De fournir des soins dentaires à un prix abordable. De renforcer les soins de santé publique. De poursuivre une véritable réconciliation avec les peuples autochtones. We're also tackling climate change across the economy through everything from huge projects that are cutting pollution on an industrial scale to a price on pollution that puts a quarterly rebate worth hundreds of dollars in people's pockets. This summer has been marked by terrifying and devastating wildfires from coast to coast to coast. Communities have watched fires destroy their homes and businesses, and virtually no place in Canada has been left untouched by dangerous air quality due to the smoke. Climate policies are more urgent than ever. Canadians cannot afford leaders who want to roll them back. In these times, Canadians need a government that believes in them and invests in their future. No one, not one, that thinks damaging cuts are the solution to everything. Our economy is strong and growing, with the second highest GDP growth in the G7 this year, second only to the United States. And almost 1 million more Canadians have jobs than before the pandemic. And wages are going up. Our government is making sure that as our economy grows, it remains an economy that works for all Canadians. Canada is the best country in the world. Let's make it even better. Merci.